Have you ever experienced traveling on a plane? Well, the majority of us enjoy spending hours in the air before reaching our destination. However, because everything is distant in space and scientists need to witness a significant event in an instant during their exploration, they need to travel more quickly. Because of this, scientists aim to find a solution to this difficulty and a means of traveling faster than light in order to reach outer space as fast as they can. But is it really possible? For the record, every strategy they believed would be effective has major disadvantages. Be at ease though. Finally, researchers have found a method for traveling faster than light. I'll explain this new method to you in this video, along with how it functions. We are also going to answer questions like, what do they need to provide for it to function, and how quickly can astronomers travel using it? So what are you waiting for? Let's get this started. We must first understand the significance of light in our life. Light allows us to see things, which is one of the most amazing of its uses. Without light, there is no color. We can enjoy our outside hobbies in the daylight, including biking, picnicking, visiting parks, and many other outdoor adventures because of the sun. Along with it, humans have created artificial light sources that make life a little easier, including flashlights and streetlights, so that we can move around without accidentally bumping into things. Aside from this, one other astounding quality of light is how quickly it travels. In fact, other measurements are based on how fast it is moving. But how quickly does it travel? In a vacuum, light moves at a precise speed of 299,792,458 meters per second, which is equal to 983,571.56 feet per second. Accordingly, light can go around 186,282 miles in a single second. Really fast, isn't it? Take for instance when you turn on a light in a dark room. It almost immediately fills the space without you being aware of its movement. Up next, let's talk about the different units of measurement involving light: the light year, light second, and light minute. The light year tells us about the range in which light can travel in a single year, which is approximately 6 trillion miles or 10 trillion kilometers away. It is one method by which astronomers and physicists gauge the vast distances present across the universe. Astronomers spent many years traveling from one region of the universe to another because of how large it is. To understand light second, consider this. It takes the moon's light approximately 1 second to reach our eyes. In other words, the moon is around 1 light second away. For the light minute, consider how long it takes for sunlight to reach our eyes, which is around 8 minutes. That means we are around 8 light minutes away from the sun. Alpha Centauri, the nearest star system from us, is about 4.3 light years away, which means that it takes its light approximately 4.3 years to arrive here. Given these measurements, we can detect other stars and objects beyond our solar system, ranging from a few light years to billions of light years. This is why everything that astronomers observe in the universe is extraordinary and needs to be documented. When they examine distant objects, they observe the light that depicts off those objects as they were at the moment the light hit them. Now, researchers are working to develop a method of traveling even faster than light. This is intriguing because it means that humanity will be able to eventually live on other planets. Elon Musk, the CEO of SpaceX, began looking for a way to establish a civilization on Mars. But his scientists must endure at the very least 5 months of space travel before arriving on Mars. The distance between the two planets could also affect the length of travel, which may expand to almost a year, with all the danger it entails. They could, however, travel from Earth to Mars in less than 4 minutes if they could only employ a technology that could travel at the speed of light. To achieve moving at a very high speed, researchers have experimented with a wide variety of techniques. However, there has always been an issue that all approaches were unable to resolve. For instance, it is exceedingly difficult to reach 1% of the speed of light. This is due to the problem with regards to energy. We are all aware that any object in motion possesses energy called kinetic energy. The more kinetic energy you have, the faster your speed is. This means 4 times as much energy is required to make anything move twice as fast as it already is, and so on. For instance, it would take 200 trillion joules for a 110-pound object to move at 1% the speed of light. That is approximately equal to the daily energy consumption of 2 million Americans. Now consider the M-Drive, which was hailed as the device that would quickly transport mankind to the farthest side of the universe. Theoretically, this invention, which has already received a patent, works by enclosing microwaves in a shaped chamber where their bouncing generates a push. Since there is no fuel input and no thrust output, the closed chamber will appear to be moving by itself from the outside. Newton's second law, which defines force as the rate of change of momentum, serves as the basis for the M-drive. An electromagnetic, or EM, wave has a specific energy that it can transfer to a reflector at the speed of light, producing just a little force. This collated little force is what actually makes the M-drive function. The M-drive, which appears uncomplicated but in reality fundamentally flips our understanding of the principles of physics. We can only wonder how the waves begin to move, how they keep moving, and where their momentum comes from, since there is no energy going in or coming out. When the principles of physics are taken into account, if there is no understandable push, spontaneously generated momentum is impossible. This is the reason why so many scientists don't consider the M-drive to be a suitable option. Because if the M-drive is successful, a lot of what physicists believe to be true about the universe will be taken as wrong claims. Physicists at the Dresden University of Technology claimed the M-drive, wherein they found out the results gathered by NASA and Chinese were inaccurate, and that thrust can be then explained by other influences. But according to Dr. Eric Lentz, a physicist with more than 10 years of experience in practical applications, the warp drive exhibits enormous power. However, it is important to note that it wasn't Lentz who first worked on converting the warp drive into a practical, non-fictional technology. It was Miguel Alcubierre, a mathematician from Mexico, who made the first attempt in 1994. His idea served as the foundation for the official warp drive literature. Unfortunately, his idea, the Alcubierre warp drive, demands a really high amount of energy, as well as an exotic matter. The problem is that the co-ingredient exotic matter hasn't been seen by any researcher and hasn't been developed by any scientists, making the warp drive still theoretical. Since then, a few modifications have been proposed, including a physical redesign of the Alcubierre drive by former NASA engineer Dr. Harold G. White. The drive he developed requires less energy than Alcubierre's original design. It was still not put to use, though, because it needed exotic material. What do you think about these developments so far? Before we continue, I just want to remind you that if you've made it this far into the video, you're clearly enjoying it. Give it a like, subscribe so you don't miss anything, and let us know what you think in the comments section. To continue, Applied Physics, or APL, consisting of researchers from Switzerland, proposed as well. Their drive was different from the ones I've mentioned in that it did not require any exotic materials to produce its warp bubble. However, their model also failed because it could not exceed the speed of light. Then, this is the time when Dr. Eric Lentz comes in to describe how his idea differs from those that have been already put out. Lentz begins by referencing the physical construction of the traditional Alcubierre drive, which is practically the basis of all other models. He claimed that the Alcubierre approach offered an understandable illustration of what a warp drive would accomplish, specifically, reduce the area directly in front of the center region housing the ship or spacecraft and enlarge the area behind. He then contends that while the Alcubierre approach is the foundation of warp travel, it is not even the most important component. He believed that the most crucial element was a solution put forth by physicist José Natario in 2002, which demonstrated that expansion and contraction were not required to move the spacecraft forward. Because of this solution, Lentz reconsidered that a warp drive could be made using only regular matter and without the use of any exotic matter. Natario was able to demonstrate that they could still accomplish the same objective of moving a spacecraft even if there is no expansion. This is an important development because it eliminates the need for exotic matter that nearly all previous proposals require. Using Notario's theory, Lentz has developed his own variation, which he thinks is more practical because it is grounded in traditional physics. His approach differs from Alcubierre in the way the energy is distributed around the warp bubble. In the Alcubierre solution, the energy density and curvatures are separated from one another to the maximum extent possible, whereas Lentz's model has closely associated curvatures and sources, with nearly perfect overlaps between the high energy density and high expansion and contraction zones. Lentz's idea is perhaps more feasible as a warp solution than those initially proposed, because of the geometrical differences between it and conventional ideas. Even though his drive model is still a theory, he believes that he can do something to turn the theory into reality, and even include a capability in his model that lowers the amount of energy required. But the question is, what will Lentz do next? His next goal is to use a modern fission reactor to create a warp bubble that is capable of traveling at 1% the speed of light. Moreover, he is thinking of patenting his warp drive, though he believes that his idea is only a part of the big picture. Since Alcubierre's idea in 1994, there have been an increasing number of innovative warp drive designs, which give us hope that a real technology that can travel at the speed of light can be achieved. The recent rapid advancements in warp drive technology have been encouraging. In the upcoming years, perhaps even greater progress will be accomplished. What do you think about the Lentz model and all the concepts around the speed of light? Let us know in the comments section. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Please click the bell icon so you'll be notified when new videos are posted. And as always, thanks for watching Ponder This.